Drew and T are on a special buying trip to Portugal, and in the heart of the capital, Lisbon, they're checking out the oldest antique store in the country.
Oh, wow.
I don't know where to look next.
Drew is going head-to-head with a second-generation dealer over two busts and a statue.
5.5. Yeah. The three pieces.
I was thinking 4.
No.
Well, think about it. Nothing is definitely in life.
What price did you put on him alone?
3. I think it's a fair price.
We're not a million miles apart. 5,000.
She's the boss now. She's the boss now. I buy.
We'll meet you in the middle, 5.3.
Is that a Portuguese middle?
Yes.
Yes, thank you very much.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Well, that's close enough. 5,003, split it between the three of them. That's great. If we sell them all, we're doing well. There's one I don't really want to sell, but the other two will pay for it.
And before Drew and T head off, Manuel's invited them to take a look at some pieces in his warehouse, just around the corner.
It's an 18th century house.
Yeah.
And then they built on top.
I'm looking at it going, is this your warehouse? Completely untouched, original paint, finishes, staircase, handles, everything, you know. The excitement's already building. Oh, wow. Oh, God.
You want one?
Yeah, please. Look at those.
Fine.
Oh, my God. This stuff's been in here 4 to 5 decades, untouched, unrestored, dumped in the corner, left.
Yeah.
Look at those. Look, yeah. This.
They're fantastic.
Wow. What we're looking at are the remnants of architectural elements, carved timber fragments. Majority of it's ecclesiastical, 17th century to early 18th century, but of high ornamentation. Amongst it all is some stuff that's better than you're going to find in national collections, in worldwide museums. Some of the best carving I've ever seen. That's a tree trunk.
Yeah, just a piece of wood.
One piece of wood.
Yes. So it's part of a church that I bought it in the 1980s. I sold a lot, but I still have a lot.
This is it. The dream is becoming reality. The magic that I'm talking about in this business is happening right before my eyes, right in front of me, and I'm part of it, and I can't believe it.
There's more. Let's keep coming.
Ah. Look down there. Look.
Oh, wow, yeah. What is it? So it's a cornice?
Yes.
Running around
yes.
the back of the altar?
Yes. This is a fantastic piece.
Mm. That changes everything.
Yes.
Let's talk. If I was to buy all of these pieces, what you have left of that room, how much? I have a figure in mind, but
I have a figure. I know, but I can always say yes or no, but...
8,000? I know he's going to say no, and I'm happy for him to say no, because but we're talking now. Price has gone out, price has come back. Ball's in his court. Give me a price.
You want me to give you a fair price?
Fair price, but we have to see all of it out.
Of
but give me a figure that we can work with.
I think it'll be around 12.
12,000.
12,000. Okay. It can go to 16, but it'll be around 12.
I trust you.
Once Manuel and his team have dusted off and laid out the complete collection, Drew plans to return in a few days to confirm the deal.
It's an extraordinary find. It's one of the best finds of my career. And honestly, if he'll sell it to me for anywhere around the £12,000 mark, I've had the bargain of the year. Thank you so much for saying, Manuel. A pleasure.
It was a pleasure.
Thank you.
Hope to see you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
An exceptional day, topped off by everything I've ever wanted in the antiques trade, condensed into 4 very shabby, worn-out, beautiful rooms in the back streets of Lisbon. That's where the antiques business can take you. That's where the magic of this trade can take you. And it's a wonderful thing.
The following day, Drew's returning to Sola to meet Veronica to feast his eyes on the full uncovered collection of architectural salvage, which bowled him over a few days ago.
We had a sort of a gentleman's agreement at 12,000 from what we could see there. But I've got a feeling the price is going to go up. I'm excited. This is what it's all about. This is it. Right. Here we are again.
Yeah. Show you the rest you haven't seen. We just scratched the surface.
Really? There's that much?
Yeah. Come on in.
Come on, Adam. Go.
Whoa. Right. Okay. So what's your father said now?
Kid, you need to talk with him.
Okay. Great. Yeah, good.
Shall we call him?
Let's call him.
Stab.
Hello, you're on speakerphone. I have Drew here. He has seen the complete set, so now you two can discuss.
I've seen everything now. What are your thoughts?
I think it's worth more than what we have seen the other day.
Because, yes, okay.
I think a fair price.
Yeah.
I think it's it will be 20,000.
Yeah, my mind said 16,000.
No, really, the best I can do it is 20,000. Otherwise, it's not worth selling.
Okay, can we call you back?
Yes,
five minutes. I just need to have a quick look at everything again. Yes, I've only briefly looked at everything.
Okay.
All right.
Problem.
Thanks. Bye.
Okay. Bye.
Okay, that's exactly what I thought you were going to say. Honestly, it's a very realistic price for the package. I give him a poke just to see whether or not it'll come down. No. Okay, fine. This is amazing, fantastic. There is four times what I saw in there. It's astonishing, it's exciting. You've got to slow right down, breathe, look at it, be realistic. Take it in, don't be overawed. Weigh it up, what can I get for it? And I'm saying all of that, I'm not doing it. Right, I'm going, wow, look at this.
Manuel sourced this impressive collection of early 18th century chestnut wood from the main altar of a Catholic church in Porto, the country's second city. Catholicism has long been Portugal's largest Christian denomination, beginning in 44 AD, when the Iberian Peninsula was first ruled by the Roman Empire. Handcrafted over several months by a skilled team of architects, woodcarvers, and gilders, this collection could fetch around £35,000.
Ah, okay, all of this as well.
Yes.
Right. I'm just getting my head around how to sell it.
Yeah.
And my heart was saying, let's put this together as a spectacular package and the opportunity for somebody to buy this and build something out of it. Reality, the only way to make a profit out of it is to break it all up, sell it off in sections. I've got to find somebody with an amazing imagination.
Yep.
This isn't something, you know, you buy it on a Monday and you're selling it on Wednesday. You've got to be quite strategic in how something like this is sold, and there's a lot of work. You can clean it and solidify some loose sections. How long is that going to take? Weeks to do it properly. Okay, let's get him on the phone.
Yep. Drew is back on.
Hi, Manuel. Okay,
hi.
I've had a good look at everything. Yeah, 20,000 sold.
Okay, okay. If you regret it, I'll buy it back from you.
Okay, deal.
Deal, okay.
Thank you very much. It's really you appreciated okay. The time and effort you put in. Really appreciate
yes,
it. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Cool.
Yeah?
Yeah, that's great. I'm happy.
I'm good. I'm happy.
I'm nuts, but I'm happy. This is what it's all about for me. Exciting, untouched, not seen, hidden treasure, you know? It's nuts. £20,000 plus all the costs involved for a load of broken bits of wood. I can pretty much guarantee there's two sections in here that are going to get me the lion's share of my money back. And then I've got to be clever, take my time with the rest of it. But my God, the history and the beauty and everything that's wrapped up in there. I think I've had the deal of the year.